Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I said to my dad on the way in there, I definitely felt very comfortable out there. I knew, it's funny, I knew the putt I had on seven was to take the lead on my own, which is, you know, it's nice. Little milestone. So I'm quite aware of what's going on around me. But yeah, my game is good. Feel very comfortable out there. Quite happy that, you know, we didn't have another four holes to play. It's been a long day. So looking forward to getting out there tomorrow. I mean, you know, this is right where you want to be. Really looking forward to tomorrow.
So you would rather be coming back early in the morning than have had to stay out there and play?
Yeah, I mean, like, I was getting kind of, you know, I was getting tired towards the end. I wasn't hitting any bad shots or anything. I was making good decisions and I was hitting good shots. And but yeah, I mean, if I had to play another four holes, it would have been quite difficult. So happy we get to come out on fresh greens. The greens were a little bit bumpy there as you know, the last couple of holes, and you know, some fresh greens in the morning, and you know, hopefully I can go out and just make a few pars and, you know, do what I've been doing all week. I've just been trying to make a few pars and see where that's going to leave me.
How much does the Akron win last year mean to
what
you're able to do out here this week?
Yeah, obviously means a lot, because I beat a field of this quality already, so there's no reason I can't go out and do it again tomorrow.
Jason was just here saying he watches the scoreboard and he was kind of watching, trying to catch you guys. I mean, did you pay attention during a round?
I do.
You look up and see your name atop the leaderboard of a US Open and kind of...
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I said to my caddy Dermot, I said, that's a little milestone. He was trying to talk me down off my pedestal that I was on. And then I went ahead and bogeyed the next hole, but... not through many bad shots, but yeah, I mean, it's you know, I'm not shy in saying that I watch the leaderboards and I like to know where I stand. You know, it's up to me then to go and hit the good shots. So yeah.
Do you really like this course?
Obviously, yeah.
Yeah. But I mean, so you like
tomorrow to win this
tournament? I do. I'll answer yours first. I do really like the place. I mean, when I got here on Sunday, how am I going to get around here? Tried to come up with a game plan at the start of the week. You know, just tried to feel comfortable around the place. I've been doing quite well so far with my game plan, and you know, if I stick to that tomorrow, God knows where I'll be tomorrow evening.
Jason was just talking about how well you're obviously playing with your score, and he said, you know, it's going to be tough, but you're going to be the guy everybody's chasing tomorrow. I mean, going into the final round, we haven't finished the third round yet, but right now you're the guy everybody's chasing. How does it feel to be that guy in a major?
Yeah, it's cool. You know, I've never been here before, so it's obviously new. Literally just come off the golf course, so looking forward to getting home and getting my dinner, and hopefully getting a good night's sleep. We have a very early start in the morning. We're back in position at 7 o'clock, so you know, hopefully I can go out and finish off my round and should have a few hours break then before I play my final round.
You seem to be thinking very clearly, looking very relaxed. When was the last time you were thinking as clearly, playing as well and feeling as relaxed as you are?
It's quite a while ago now. You know, it's probably around this time last year. You know, you look back at Akron and look at the week I had at the US Open last year. You know, I'm in a good frame of mind.
How long has it been since that putter has felt so comfortable in your hand?
It's got quite a while. I'm not going to say much because I don't want to jinx myself for tomorrow, but it's been, you know, I haven't felt that comfortable on the greens in quite a while. So, yeah, they are perfect greens. I mean, I know they're quick, but they're absolutely perfect greens. So, you know, you have no excuses around here.
Jason said he hopes it's hot and dry tomorrow, so that makes it tougher. But, I mean, if it's hot and dry tomorrow, doesn't it also make the guy in the lead tougher to catch?
I mean, we all know that this course can jump up and bite you in a split second. So yeah, I'm two ahead with whatever. I've got 22 holes left, but you know, let's not get ahead of ourselves. There's the best golfers in the world behind me. You know, you look at Dustin and Jason and guys like that, and you know, Sergio played lovely today with me as well. So yeah, I mean, like I said, I just have to go out and do what I've been doing all week. I mean, I'm really looking forward to tomorrow. This is exactly where you want to be. Like, I've been beating myself up over the last sort of 6 months trying to get into this position, and I'm here now, so I might as well enjoy it when I'm here.
Okay, thanks, Shane.
Thanks.